Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we'll talk about what are the benefits of Corona. Every one of us is talking about the negative side of the pandemic of Corona and how we protect ourselves from it. I'd like to take you out of this dark and gloomy atmosphere to talk about something which is extremely important. We understand that light always comes out of darkness. Day come out of night and goodness come out of evil. And what are the benefits of Corona and Corona's benefits? I've got 31 points. I wish that you can be patient with me. The first one is decreasing the number of terrorist activities affecting the globe, whether in the east or the west or north and south, because the donor agencies, the donor individual, and the donor governments actually are very busy spending their money on their countries, in their countries, and trying to save their governments in the country. This is number one. Number two, changing the social culture discourse and rhetoric on the social media platform. It becomes more serious. Social media now and the messaging and the messages become more serious than it was before and more positive than it was before. Most of the discussion on platform, on such a platform, is about how to protect yourself, how to protect your family, how to protect your country, how to protect the planet itself. Number three of benefits is increasing the data, the amount of data on social media about the pandemic and sharing it between, not between the members of the same group, but between different groups in different countries having different cultural background, even speaking different languages. Number four, changing the values and the culture of messaging and messages on the social media. As I mentioned earlier, we used to see and receive and hear very dubious and stupid messages and culture of messaging on the social media. Number five, weakening the voices of the state media. The media which is supported totally by the state become extremely weak. Also, the media which is supported by governments, supported by the state, becomes extremely weak and unreliable, because people on the social media, like all of you, are looking and searching for truth and find the difference between the information on the state media and the information of the independent media. And even each one of you on the social media become a media platform himself or herself. Number six, young people like all of you on social media become social reformers, giving advices on social life, on economy, on religious values, on humanitarian values and others. You are becoming social reformers. Number seven, the level of social awareness on social media is on the rise among the individuals who started to differentiate between the fake and wrong theological and religious messages and the good ones. They started to search, to listen to Mr. X and Y and Z and find the difference between the state sheikh or the state imam or the state monk or the state rabbi or the state priest and the independent one who is really, he or she are extremely sincere and honest to them. The rising trend, number eight, the rising trends of religious speeches amongst the Western political leaders, and the decline and the lack of confidence in other ideologies, secularism, capitalism, liberalism, socialism, communism, and others, because people now are starting to turn back to God, as they think that actually morality is the cornerstone of the ruling and the life as well. The world realized that now that the scientific power of discovery is diminishing, because they can do nothing about the vast spread of the virus from the far east in Wuhan to the far west in actually Los Angeles in America. And they have to realize that actually there's a mighty power called the Creator who is in charge of the planet, not them, the science and technology. Number 10, closing down the bad places and the bad and immoral places like prostitution and discos and bars and where it was distracting young people in this area. This most of them, if not all of them, most of them are closing down or actually not functioning at the moment. Number 11, individual expenditure, you and me, become focused in our expenditure on what we really need, our necessity. Food, drink, medicine, maybe clothes. No extra expenses. No extra expenses being spent on drinking, on boozing, on alcohol, on drugs, or narcotics, or whatever you call it, or smoking. People saving money because they don't know what they are going to face in 6 months' time, with will they be losing their jobs or they have, will be in job. Number 12, the downfall of the corrupt. Here we can talk about the Muslim leadership. The downfall of the corrupt Muslim political leaders, whom their theory and theology and philosophy of thinking about modernity, modernist civilization, civilized people and others is only free sex between men and women, free sex between men and men and women and women, actually, and doing all, following all those dubious, strange ideology and bringing it to their countries and thinking that actually if they open pubs or casinos or discos or whatever you call it, this is the sign of modernity and the sign of civilization, okay? Not only that, fighting their own religion by themselves and imprisoning the religious leaders, the honest, credible, integral religious leaders. So there's a downfall in their approach to build their own country, their own nation, their own state. Another number 13 point is decreasing the amount of torture being given by the security officers to the detainees and the political prisoners who are innocent and being put in jail by the dictatorship scheme or the regime. You know why? Because not because the security men are believing in the human rights and this principle, but because those men, security men, are scared of God. Why? Because they knew that such individuals imprisoned in front of them are honest, are not criminals. So they are the fear of God on the at the back of the mind of the security personality. Number 14, the corrupt judiciary system in the dictatorship state stopped issuing the decree or the statement or the decision of death sentences anymore. It used to have like this in certain countries. Life imprisonment anymore, it used to be like this. Stop now. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Number 15, the rise of spending on social services by such dictatorship state. Not because they love to serve the people, but because they wanted to save themselves and their ruling and their control on the resources of their country. Number 16, the value of the family and the family values, which we lost it. We lost it. It's on the rise amongst the public domain. The family in front of myself means the male father, the female mother, the children, and the relatives and the connection, okay? It's on the rise and everybody now need to relate himself or herself to a family. Number 17, increasing the time spent with the children at home, especially by the father, because mother used to see the children 24/7, but father is very, very busy working outside. Now both at home realizing the value of how to bring their children up and how to look after them. Number 18, the rise of the spirit of volunteerism and community initiatives amongst whom? Amongst the old, the elderly, and the young. The male and the female, everybody want to do something to save himself, his family, his community, his society, his country, the planet itself. Everybody wants to become a volunteer to help at that time. Number 19, understanding the value and the credibility of civil society organization. Now we realize that we need more and more and more civil society organization to help the government, to support the nation, and to build the infrastructure of the country. Number 20, to changing the culture of social and the voluntary service, and this for the people in charge of the social service and the voluntary service sector. Changing the culture of social and voluntary services sector, and the rise of new young political and social leaders on the social media platform. They'll come out of this world or this to the real world. Number 21, the rise of individual needs to mix with home, to mix with community, to mix with society, to mix with people, not to live in isolation, depending only on our income or our materialistic resource in our hand and isolating ourselves. Now, each and every one of those young people who earn maybe 100,000 a year or 200,000, 300,000 found that the money is not the source of happiness. It's being with the people, talking to the people, listening to the people, helping the people is the source of happiness. Number 22 is the appearance or the development or the rise or the of what? Of new social professions. What? With new social culture on social media. And social media, with the young people there, are producing new professions which was not there in the past. This kind of innovative and pioneering skills is on the rise at the back of the mind of the young people who are using the social media, because they have the time to think, to develop, and to deliver. Number 23 will be seeing the end of those corrupt global organizations, whether they are social, political, economical, or whatever it is. Because the corruption is not of the organization itself by itself, but because of the bad governments and the member states who are actually corrupting such organizations. We would see an end of these corrupt organizations and corrupt governments as well. Number 24, we'll be seeing the end of armed conflict in different areas, because this armed conflict groups is supported by this government. Now, as we talked earlier about the diminishing number of the terrorist activities by the terrorist group because of the supporting government, or the support government is actually busy doing something else, this will also happen onto the man-made planned armed conflicts and controlled by actually different countries. This will be on the diminishing as well. Number 25, observing the rise of investment in what? In medical field and pharmaceutical field as well by the government. Number 26, governments and organizations will believe in research and they'll spend more money on research and they'll increase the budget of research in their countries and in their organization. Number 27, we have seen the decline or the fall down of environmental pollution. Why? Because the industrial countries stop to produce the poisons which actually polluting the whole planet, actually. And this will impact positively the climate change itself. It will have a positive climate change, not the negative climate change that we was having before. Number 28 will be discovering the source and the causes of the pandemic. And as it happened in a city called Wuhan, we have seen the eating habits of those people, and we hope that actually they can stop eating unpalatable kind of food which is harmful for themselves and harmful for humanity as well. Number 29, each and every one of us will follow the public health principles, hygiene and personal cleanliness, which become closer or closest to how the Muslims clean themselves every day, especially when they make wudu and they wash their hands, their arms, their legs, their feet, and rinse their mouths and blow their noses 15 times a day, each one of them. Then others as well. Number 30, the rising social awareness towards what? Littering, the way we throw things outside. Chemical and nuclear dumping, recycling, actually, which could be the main reason of having this pandemic. Number 31, which is the last, is we will witness the birth of the new world order. The center of the global power would be shifting from the far west to the central, from the far west to the central, from the far west to the central, actually of the globe. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ شَهِيدًا. That's how we have created you as a balance, middle way, Ummah, to witness, to be the witness on humanity. And the Prophet ﷺ will witness for you. So here the shift of power will be happening at the end of the coronavirus pandemic. I mentioned to you 31 points of benefit could be coming out of the coronavirus pandemic. I hope that we'll find some more positive out of the negative, more light out of the darkness, and more goodness out of the evil of the coronavirus pandemic. I will ask you to watch my second video about the birth of the new world order, which will be in a week's time. But at the time, at now, I ask each and every one of you, I thank you for watching the video, and I request you to press to activate the notification bell and to share the video with your colleague. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.